Good evening. So in the previous class, we have seen this thing about how to connect it with how to link them with this IP, how to link this IP addresses and all with this root 53 algorithm, right? So yeah, I think yesterday we didn't get this output, right? That's only because of this connectivity issues. And it's the same procedure how we connect root them with this DNS name, this domain server name, with this domain name server, and with the how we link it with this IP address. So it's the same procedure. After the class, I've done the same thing again and I got it. So yeah, that's a that's standard procedure how we do it. So today we are going to look at this, we are done with VPC, CloudFront, and Route 53, right? So now today we are going to look at this API gateway and also with this direct connect. So coming to this API gateway, what is this API gateway? So this API gateway is an AWS service that enables developers to create, publish, maintain, monitor, and secure APIs at any scale. So you can create these APIs that access AWS or other web services. So as well, the data is stored in this AWS cloud. So yeah. And coming to this topics which fall under this API gateway are, the first one is this gateway to AWS cloud, and coming to this developer's experience and the benefits of API gateway, and this API gateway concepts and gateway pricing. Gateway to AWS cloud and beyond. So it can be considered as a back panel in the cloud, which connects this AWS services and other public or private websites. So it provides consistent RESTful application program interfaces for mobile and web applications to access this AWS services. So this following diagram shows this API gateway architecture. So here, this is the architecture. So this is a gateway here. We have this APIs. And these are the applications which we will be using. So this API gateway is there, right? It will be connecting these services to these APIs with the internet connection. So here we can see this, right? This is the Lambda function, EC2, S3, and the virtual private cloud here. So here all our services are linked up and will be provided. We can actually use these APIs to get them. So this gateway lets you create, configure, and host a RESTful APIs to enable applications to access the AWS cloud. So here, so now we are following this documentation because anyway we have to refer for it. So anyways, we have to refer this documentation, right? So I've done the recording, but this recording is done on the previous version of this AWS website. So it would be better if we follow this documentation part and then look at how to do handle these things. So here we can an application can call an API in API gateway to upload a user's annual income and expense data to Amazon S3 or DynamoDB and process data in Lambda to compute tags owed and file a return via this IRS website. So here, this whole thing, so this in this example, we are going to look at user is there, right? He is calling an API where this his annual income and the expenses data will be given to this, will be stored in this S3 or DynamoDB. So we want an application which process the data in Lambda and compute the tax owed and file the tax returns. So here he wants some function or some he wants an application which can process the whole data to compute the tax owed and to file a return. So here an application. An app gains programmatic access to these AWS services or website on the internet through one or more APIs, which are hosted in API gateway. So this app is at the API's front end. So the integrated AWS services and the website are located at the API's backend. In this API gateway, this front end is encapsulated by method requests and method responses. And at the backend, it is encapsulated by integration requests and integration responses. So when we look at this diagram here, we have this applications, right? So similarly, we'll be having our application here, and we have this API gateway here, and we have our API here. So here within our API, this method request and the method responses are encapsulated. And for this API for this application to process, it requires data which is either stored in this S3 or this DynamoDB, and it requires Lambda function to calculate the tax thing and all. So this API is linked to this Lambda and either this DynamoDB or S3. So this Lambda will be functioning, like will be calculating the taxes part based on the user's data, which is either stored in the DynamoDB or S3. So this is how this APIs work. So with this Amazon API gateway, you can build an API to provide your users with an integrated and consistent developer experience to build AWS cloud-based applications. That means you can actually here in the previous example, we have seen this, right? This user want a particular application or a particular process to run on the data, for evaluating the taxes owed and to file a tax return. So here he can either build his own application there, or he can he can actually take an application or take an API which is already built and is placed in the marketplace. So in this AWS API marketplace, there's many people will be developing these APIs and will be publishing them in the marketplace, so that you don't have to build your own API if you're based on your requirement. Based on your requirement, if any API matches your requirement, you can actually use it, and you'll be paying for what you use. Instead, you don't have to you don't have to build your own API from scratch. So it is a part of AWS serverless infrastructure. So together with this AWS Lambda, API gateway forms the app facing part. That is this application facing part, that means a front end of the AWS serverless infrastructure. So for an app to call publicly available AWS services, you can use Lambda to interact with the requested services and expose the Lambda function through API methods in the API gateway. So here what he is trying to tell us is this API gateway forms this application facing part, that means a front end, and this application has to access or take services, right? So for this thing, Lambda is used. So Lambda is used to interact with the requested services, and you will be exposing, and this Lambda is there, right? This is we'll be exposing this Lambda functions through API methods in the API gateway. So this AWS Lambda runs the code on highly available computing infrastructure. So it performs the necessary execution and administration of computing resources to enable the serverless application. API gateway supports streamlined proxy integrations and all. So here we can see this developer's experience, right? So here, based on this thing, we have two kind of developers. The first one is the application developers, and the other one are these API developers. So these application developers are here, right? So an application developer builds a functioning application to call AWS services by invoking API methods in API gateway. So, you know, like if you are doing, or if you are going to build an facial recognition system or your facial recognition application, so what you'll be doing is you will be developing this application which suits this face recognition API or which fits with this face recognition API. So the main part in the face recognition thing is to recognize your face, or to recognize the faces which are previously stored in the data sets or the databases. So this app developers will be developing an application which fits with this API, this face recognition API. So coming to this API developer, an API developer creates and deploys an API to enable the required functionality in API gateway. So this API developers must be an IAM user in the AWS account that owns the API. That means this API developers create these APIs and all, and they'll be like to enable the required functionalities in the API gateway. So if you take this face recognition system, whatever the things which are required for this face recognition system are in are connected to this application or to this API in the API gateway. So all these things are done by this API developers. And this API developers are there, right? They must have this IAM user in the AWS account that owns this API. And coming to this app developers, they don't they doesn't need to have an AWS account actually. And which provides that this API either does not require IAM permissions or supports authorization of users through third-party applications and blah. So yeah, the main part here is application developers do not have this AWS account, and they don't have to be this IAM users and all. So in the marketplace, we have three, coming to the APIs, we have three things. The first one is we will be developing the API based on our requirement. And the second one is we will be choosing an API if at all it fits our requirement. So if it does the same as our requirement, as a model which we want, we will be taking it from the marketplace. And when it comes to this custom predefined APIs which are being provided by this Amazon and all, no, you can actually directly use those APIs. So here we are talking about this third thing, predefined APIs. Such identity providers include this Amazon user pools and Facebook, Google's and all. So yeah, coming to this, so creating and managing an API gateway here is, so here we'll be creating and managing the APIs in the API gateway. So what are the steps required? An API developer must works with this API gateway service component in the for the API management named API gateway to create, configure and deploy an application. So in order to, you know, to create and configuring and deploying an application, he must work with the API management components, that is this API gateway. This, like, each API includes a set of resources and methods. So yeah, every application, if we take this face recognition application, no, it requires some resources, previously stored faces that are in the database. So here they need this storage resources and a lambda function or a similar function which can actually tell that this face is already in the database or something like this. And we have this methods. So coming to this methods, we can actually relate it with the algorithms which calculate the faces or which tells that, which compares the faces. And a resource is a logically entity, is a logical entity that an application can access through a resource path. Okay. And here, this method, a method corresponds to this API request that is submitted by the user of your API, and then and the response is returned to the user. So here in we have seen the red, we have this method request and the method responses. So that's it, that is what here he's telling us. And this, the app doesn't need not to, like, the app does not need to know where the requested data is stored and fetched from the backend. So this application, it don't actually bother, or it is least bothered about where this data is stored and where it is from, where it is fetching and all that. And the API interfaces with the backend by means of integration requests and integration responses. So this interfaces with the backend by means of this request and the responses. So as an API developer, you can create and manage an API by using the API gateway console. So here that is described in this getting started with the Amazon API gateway, or you can actually call it by this API gateway REST API. There are several ways to call this API. That includes AWS command line interface, or by using this SDKs. And you can also use a REST API client such as Postman to make this raw API calls. In addition, you can enable this API creation with AWS Cloud Formation Template or API Gateway extension to open API. So this coming to this calling an API gateway API, an app developer works with the API gateway service component for API execution, named this execute API. To invoke an API that was created or deployed in the API gateway, the underlying programming entities are exposed by this created API. So here there are several ways to call such APIs. You can actually use the API gateway console to test invoking the API. You can use a REST API client such as this curl or Postman, or an SDK generated by this API gateway to invoke this API. And so here there are difference between this API gateway and execute API. So API gateway, both are actually different things. And coming to this benefits of API gateway, it helps you deliver the robust, secure and scalable mobile and web application backends. This API gateway allows you to securely connect with mobile and web applications to business logic hosted on AWS Lambda. And this API is hosted on Amazon EC2 or other publicly addressable web services hosted inside or outside of AWS. So here what it is trying to tell us is this API gateway can easily be integrated to mobile and web applications for the business logics also. With this API, you can create and operate APIs for backend services. For example, you don't need to develop and maintain infrastructure to handle authorization authorization and access control, traffic management, monitoring and analytics, version management and software development kits, generations and all. So now we'll look at this getting started with an API. So with this Amazon API gateway, you can provide your clients with a consistent and scalable programming interface to access three types of endpoints in the backend. That is invoking this AWS Lambda. AWS Lambda function calling other AWS services and accessing an HTTP website or web page to do this. Website or web page. To do this, you create an API gateway API to integrate with API payments. So here what it is telling us is we can actually create an API in the API marketplace to access, and we'll be linking them with the other services with the help of this AWS Lambda. And to get started with this API gateway, we must know about this creating and deploying and testing simple APIs integrated with some commonly used backends. The example APIs used in the walkthroughs demonstrate what is involved to implement each of the supported integration types. So now, what are all the topics here are? Get ready to build an API gateway API and build an API gateway API from an example. Build it with Lambda integration, with the HTTP integration, with the gateway private integration, and with this AWS integration. Get ready, we'll be seeing this ready to build an API gateway API. So first of all, we have to sign up in AWS account, and we have to create our IAM user groups, roles and policies of your AWS account, which we have already covered. And we have to, for this, for configuring this API gateway, have to update this policy here. So with this policy, it help, like it grants a permission to a user, and it allows this application server, like the server instance, to link it up with this API gateway. So yeah, here to here we have this thing, right? To control how an API is invoked, the following AWS managed IAM policy. So we have to update the IAM policy also. So it has the full access here. So yeah, we now see this API gateway for an example. So to help you getting started with this basic workflow to build and test an API gateway API, you can use this Amazon API gateway console to create and test simple API with HTTP integration. So here he's talking about creating it or building an API gateway for a particular website. So the example API supports the following methods for a client to access the HTTP backend website of HTTP Petstore. Here is a link for the Petstore website. And for this function, like for this call get, it is for read access to this API's roots resources that is not integrated with any backend for any backend endpoint. API gateway responds with an overview of the Petstore website. So this is a example of this mock integration type. Coming to this get pets now, for the read access to the APIs, pets resources that is integrated with the like named backends, pets resource. So this backend returns a page of available pets in the pet store. This is an example of HTTP integration type. So the URL of the integration endpoint will be HTTP pet store demo endpoint dot execute API pet store pets. And coming to this post pets now, coming to like a where, like when it comes to this get and post, you know, you can actually see the data which is being sent with this get thing. And whereas this post hides the information which is sending, like which is being sent. So for write access to this API page resource that is integrated with the backend, but backend thing, upon receiving a correct request, the backend adds the specified pet to the pet store and returns the result to the caller. So the integration is also HTTP. And coming to this get pets with this pets ID, for read access to pet to a pet as identified by a pet ID. So with this pet ID, you can actually read or access that particular element with this pet ID. So this API supports course access via the all these options. So here you can create and test API with this thing, and yeah. And now we'll be looking at building it with this Lambda function, Lambda integration. So to build an API with the Lambda integration, you can use either the Lambda proxy integration or the Lambda custom integration. So in general, you should use this Lambda proxy integration for nimble and streamlined API setup while providing versatile and powerful features. The custom integration may be a better value proposition if it is necessary for API gateway to pre-process incoming request data before it reaches to backend Lambda function. However, it is a legacy technology. Like setting up Lambda custom integration is more involved than setting up Lambda proxy integration, and existing setup is likely to be inoperable. Like anyway, we don't like, you know, in general, we'll not be using this API gateway API with this Lambda integration, because we don't actually need that thing. But when it comes to integrating it with this Lambda integration, you know, it requires, so like the requirement will be a little high. So if it requires a lot of processing work, or it has to provide services to multiple clients or multiple users at the same time. So based on this requirement, no, it like you can actually integrate it with what you want, like with an example of this HTTP or with this Lambda integration. So here for this Lambda integration, you can have the links here. So how to build API gateway with the Lambda proxy integration, and API with the cross account Lambda proxy integration, and with the custom Lambda integration. So all this depends on your requirement. And how to build an API gateway API with HTTP integrations. So to build an API with HTTP integrations, you can use either the HTTP proxy integration or the HTTP custom integration. Basically, they recommend us to use this HTTP proxy integrations whenever possible for streamlined API setup while providing this versatile and powerful features. So when it comes to this custom integrations can be compelling if it is necessary to transform client request data or the backend or transform the backend response data from the clients. So what happens with this custom integration is you will be actually it is completely based on the requirement. So here it is given, right? Can be compelling if it is necessary to transform client requested data for backend or transform the backend response data to the client. Here it is a two-way communication. So the first way of communicating is sending the data from this user to the backend and getting the process, the data or the response data from backend to the user. So we can build an API with the support proxy integration and build an API with HTTP custom integration. And coming to this creating Amazon API gateway, what are all the steps here is you have to choose an endpoint type to set up this API gateway API and initialize this API setup in API gateway and set up API methods in the API gateway, set up API integrations in API gateway, and you have to set up this gateway responses to customize error responses and set up this API gateway request and response data mappings. And you even have to support this binary payloads in API gateway and enable payload compression for an API, enable this request validation for API gateway and update and maintain an API in Amazon API gateway and import an API into this API gateway. So in general, we don't go with this custom APIs because in Amazon marketplace, this in API marketplace, we already have a lot of APIs which are either provided by this Amazon or which are many people are actually building this API and hosting providing them in this API marketplace. So in most of the cases we have the APIs there which are our requirement. But when it comes to it actually depends on your application idea. If it's more complex, and you don't find any matching APIs to your application, then you will be going with this custom application. And for controlling access to an API, so this API gateway supports multiple mechanisms for controlling this access to your API. That is your resource policies, which lets you create resource-based policies to allow or deny access to your APIs and methods from specified source IP address or VPC endpoints. And this cross-origin resource sharing lets you control how your API responds to cross-domain resource requests. And your Lambda authorizers are Lambda functions that control access to your API methods using bearer tokens, using bearer token authentication as well as information described by the header, paths, query strings, stage variables, or context variables, request parameters. And when it comes to this Amazon Cognito user pools, it which like these let you create customizable authentication and authorization solutions. And this client-side SSL certificate, can we use it to verify that HTTP requests to your backend systems are from API gateway? So like in general, we'll be getting this HTTPS, right? We have this HTTPS gateway here. HTTPS, right? So initially when we develop or when we host our things in the server or sites, initially we'll be getting this HTTP. So for this HTTPS, we have to get this SSL certification. So whenever, like when after this SSL certifications are done, you know, you will be getting this HTTPS. That is what he is telling us here. And coming to this usage plans. So it they let you provide this API keys to your customers and then track and limit usage of your API stages and the methods for each API key. So what are all the topics which come under this, you know, accessing thing? They are controlled access to API with API gateway resource policies and with IAM permissions, use API gateway Lambda authorizers, control access to API using Amazon Cognito user pool, enable cores for an API gateway resource, and use this SSL certificate for authenticating by backend, and creating and create and use this usage plans with API keys. So yeah, like today we have seen this, what is this gateway and how to start with this, like how to use this gateway and how, and in this creating API, like how to create an API and how to controlling access to this API and all thing. So yeah, we have seen, so that's it for today's class. And today, in the next class, we will look at how to, like, we will look on the working of the topics which we have discussed in today's class. So yeah, tomorrow we'll do a hands-on thing. Like, I'll be showing you how to configure this APIs in this API gateway. And you know how to update the policies wherever required involved. So yeah, thank you.